Good morning. Myself Dr. Seema Garg from Arya College of Engineering and IT, Jaipur, presenting a video lecture on partial differential equation, part 3. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about the standard forms of partial differential equation. Before going to start standard forms, we must know about the different type of solutions or integrals. Complete integral, a relation between dependent and independent variable which satisfy the given differential equation, and it contains number of arbitrary constant equals to number of independent variables. Particular integral. In the complete integral, if particular values are given to the arbitrary constants, the solution obtained is particular solution. Singular integral. In the complete integral, the singular integral is obtained by the elimination of constants E and B from f equals to 0, del f upon del a equals to 0 and del f upon del b equals to 0. General integral. In the complete integral, we have two constants A and B. If from any constant, say b equals to function of another constant, say a, then the complete integral becomes given by equation number 2. Have only one constant a. The eliminate of a between relation number 2 and del f upon del a equals to 0 gives the general integral of the partial differential equation. Standard forms. Standard form first, that is function of pq equals to 0. The partial differential equation contains only the terms of p and q. The procedure to solve the standard form first is given in this slide. To solve the standard form first, we calculate the complete integral, singular integral and general integral. To understand the solution of the standard form first, we take some examples. Question number 1. Given equation is in the standard form first, function of pq equals to 0, that is the equation contains only the terms of p and q. For the solution of the standard form first, we always take the complete integral vz equal to ax plus by plus c given by equation number 2. From equation number 2, if we calculate the del z upon del x, we find a equals to p. Differentiate with respect to y, we find del z upon del y equals to q equals to b. We have p equals to a, q equals to b. So we write p equals to a and q equals to b in equation number 1. We get the relation root of a plus root of b equals to 1. Now we find the value of b in terms of a. Putting b equals to 1 minus root of a whole square in equation number 2, we get the result 3. Let us take c is the function of arbitrary constant a. Now we calculate del z upon del a equals to 0 and del z upon del c equals to 0. For the singular integral, del z upon del c equals to 0 means 1 equals to 0, which is not possible. So the singular solution does not exist in this question. For the general solution, general integral is obtained by elimination of a between equation number 3 and del z upon del a equals to 0. Question number 2. Here again, the given equation is in the standard form first. The equation contains only the terms of p and q. So we take the complete integral z equals to ax plus by plus c. So we have p equals to a, q equals to b. Putting a equals to p and b equals to 2 in equation number 1, you get the relation a square plus b square minus nab equals to 0. We find any one of the constant b or a. We calculate here b equals in terms of a. Putting b in equation number 3, we get the relation. For the singular integral, we calculate del z upon del c equals to 0. Del z upon del c equals to 0 gives 1 equals to 0, which is not possible. So, singular integral does not exist in this question. Again, for the general integral, we take c equals to function of a. And the general integral is obtained from relation z and del z upon del u equals to 0. Next question. The given differential equation is in the form of the standard form first, that is function of t, comma q equals to 0. So we take the complete integral z equal to ax plus by plus c. So we have p equals to a, q equals to b. Putting p equals to a, q equals to b in the given equation, we get b in terms of a. By putting the value of b in complete integral, we have the solution z equal to ax plus e to the power minus a upon a y plus c. Again, we see that if we take del z upon del c equals to 0, we get 1 equals to 0, which is not possible. So, singular integral does not exist in this question. For the general integral, we calculate c. We take c equals to function of a and calculate del z upon del a equals to 0. The eliminate of a between z, del z upon del a equals to 0 gives the general integral. Standard form second. Equations are of the form function of z p q equals to 0. That is, the equation which contains only the terms of p, q and z are known as standard form second. To solve the standard form second, we take a new variable capital X, which is given by x plus ay, where a is any arbitrary constant. We suppose z equals to function of capital X. We have z equals to function of xy. Xy are taken in the terms of capital X, so z equals to function of capital X. By the property of partial differentiation, we find the value of p equals to dz upon d capital X and q equals to a dz upon d capital X. So, in the standard form, we take p equals to dz by dx and q equals to a dz by dx. After substituting this, we get a variable separation method. And on integration, we get the solution. Let us take some examples to clear the standard form second. The given equation is in the standard form second. The terms containing only the terms of z, p and q. So, let z equals to function of capital X, where capital X equal to x plus a1. Substituting p equals to dz upon d capital X and q equals to a dz upon d capital X. After substituting p and q in given equation, we get this relation. And after calculating, we find the value of dz upon dx ka whole square. And by taking the square root, we have dz upon d capital X. Separate the terms of z in the left hand side and take the terms of x in the right hand side, and on integration we get the final solution. Now substituting the value of capital X, that is x plus ay, we get the required solution. We take another example for standard form second. The given equation is in the standard form second. The equation contains only the terms of P, Q and J. Again, let Z equals to function of capital X, where capital X equal to X plus A1. Substituting P equals to dz upon d capital X and Q equals to a dz by d capital X. And after solving, we find the value of dz upon d capital X. We apply variable separation method. We take the terms of z in left hand side and the terms of capital X in right hand side, and on integration and after substituting the value of X, we get the required solution. One more example of a standard form second. The given equation is in the standard form second. That is, the equation contains only the terms of P, Q and Z. Let Z equals to function of capital X, where capital X equals to X plus AY. Substituting P equals to dz by dx and Q equals to a dz by dx in the given relation, we find the value of dz upon dx after solving. Now we separate the terms of z and x. We take the values of z with along with dz in left hand side, and we take the values of capital X in the right hand side, and on integration we get the relation between capital X, Z and arbitrary constant. After substituting the value of capital X, we find the required solution of partial differential equation. The another two standard forms, that is standard form 3rd and 4th, will be discussed in next video lecture. Thank you.